What's up, guys? We are back in the lab again today with our homemade vacuum chamber. You remember we built this in a previous project, and the whole purpose of this thing is to degas silicone so we don't have air bubbles trapped in our silicone molds. The only issue I have with it is that it's made out of a pressure pot and this thing is not see-through. So if we're doing some cool experiments, we won't be able to see them. So I went down to the super center and picked up some of these glass cookie jars and wondered if they could work as an option as well. Now, this project was inspired by my cousin Ty Moser with the MonoLoco Workshop, who used one of these glass jars to build a vacuum chamber on his channel, and I'll put a link in the description to where you can see that. Now, the last thing we want with a vacuum chamber is for it to implode on us right as we're doing some work. That will spread glass all over the room, possibly into your face, and we don't want that to happen. So before we actually use these in the real world, we need to test them and make sure they're capable of holding up to the vacuum pressure. Now, you probably remember that with our pressure pot, I made a proto putty seal that can be removed and replaced. And I also did the same thing with these glass jars as well. We've got a smaller version that's blue and can be removed, and then we've got the larger version that's red. Now, when these things go onto the acrylic, they form an airtight seal because these are stretchy rubber gaskets. So I think they're gonna work really well, and I can't wait to put them to the test. Now, since I know my cousin Ty had a chamber similar to this, I'm gonna start off with this smaller one. We're gonna put it under vacuum pressure and let it sit for about 10 minutes. While it's doing that, we're gonna set up the cameras and run away so that if it does implode, we're well out of harm's way. Just for fun, I crunched up a water bottle and stuck the lid back on so we can put this inside the chamber so as we're drawing the vacuum, we can see how a crunched up water bottle reacts. I'm just using a little bit of clay at the bottom to hold the bottle in place. Pretty nice fit. The exhaust valve needs to be closed and the intake valve needs to be opened, and we're ready to go. So this is actually a pretty good sign, guys. This vacuum chamber has been running for about 5 minutes now and I don't notice anything that's concerning. Very cool that our water bottle has fully inflated. And you see on the gauge here, the vacuum pressure has dropped down about as low as it's gonna get. So this is very encouraging, guys. I've got the vacuum pump turned off and I've got both of these valves to the closed position. So in here, we still have a vacuum and you can see that because the bottle is still inflated. Now, what do you think would happen if I open the exhaust port so air can get back in? Let's watch the bottle and find out. I'm gonna put my mask on for safety though. Here we go in 3, 2, 1. How awesome is that? So the small jar worked, and honestly, that's what I was expecting, but this here is the one that makes me a little more nervous. This is a lot more volume that we're sucking out. We just need to close the exhaust valve, open the intake valve, get our safety measures in place, and run away. Here we go! Takes a little bit longer to get the air out of that one. Probably because it's a bigger jar, huh? So it looks like the bottle's fully inflated. Our gauge is down to about 25 inches of mercury, and surprisingly, the glass seems to be holding up pretty well. At this point, I'm still pretty nervous to approach it though, so let's just give it a few more minutes and see if it holds. Okay, so guys, this is actually working out really well. This is holding very nicely, and it's very encouraging because now we have a big vacuum chamber that we can use to see really cool experiments happening inside. The question though is, how much pressure would it take to set this thing off? Just joking, I'm not gonna do that in this video, but if you guys wanna see that, maybe we'll track down a slow motion camera and do that for a future experiment. Now, just because this system hasn't imploded yet doesn't mean that it won't. If there are any kind of hairline fractures in here or any weaknesses, it might just be a tap or a touch to set the whole thing off. So I'm gonna put my mask back on. Let's open this safety valve and introduce the air back into the system. Yeah, and check this out. Now the lid comes off fairly freely. What do you think would happen if we put a water bottle in there that we didn't squish the air out of? Could we get it to explode? Whoa, look, the water's boiling. Whoa! But I guess it makes sense. We've lowered the atmospheric pressure in there so much that the water has a new boiling point. Let's see what happens when we open the valve here. How cool is that? So it must have sucked air out of the bottle as well. These bottles won't burst until it gets closer to 60 or 65 PSI. So I'm gonna pressurize one of these bottles with about 50 PSI, so when we remove the air, the pressure differential should be enough to get the plastic to burst. So we got our purple bottle pumped up to 55 PSI, and if we remove the atmosphere from the bottle now, hopefully that'll be enough for it to burst the plastic and give us a nice little explosion. Here we go. Do it. Dude, how much pressure can that take? Huh, maybe it's not gonna explode. Yes! I can't believe it finally worked! So there we go, our bottle finally exploded. I was actually starting to doubt whether or not that would actually work or not. We tried that probably 6 times, and every time it would explode in my shop. Dang it! Rather than in the container. So there must be a very, very fine line. I'm not sure why it would be so difficult, but that one worked, and that's all that matters. And the other thing is, the bottle exploded, but the container is still fully intact. So that kind of alleviates my concern, because now we can see it can take a little bit of abuse and hold up. So that's good news. Look at the bottle in there. It's completely annihilated. It's completely destroyed. I think it's a combination of the pressure inside the bottle with the vacuum forces pulling it out. It just ripped that bottle to shreds. Man, it erupts with such power that it shakes the table, and you can see the camera shake a little bit. That is a lot of power. That's very cool. So it looks like our vacuum chambers are holding up. That's good news. So there you have it, guys. The results are in. Apparently, these glass cookie jars are a viable option for our vacuum chamber, which is really cool because now we can see inside the chamber as the reactions are taking place. And it doesn't hurt that we got a cool explosion out of the experiment as well. Hey, thanks for hanging out with me today. It's been awesome to have you as part of this experiment, and I'll be looking for you in the next video. Talk to you then. Dang it! Oh, wow, okay. Hey guys, thanks for watching, and remember, I'm giving away prizes now on every new video. All you have to do to qualify is subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and select to be notified when my next videos get released. The secret link to my giveaways will be pinned in the comments for the first 12 hours. If you like what I'm doing, show your support right now by giving this video a big thumbs up and share with a friend. I love you back, and I'll see you next time.